Thank you very much, Guadalupe. The next presenter is wrote a book on the history of soccer in St. Louis, Dave Lang. And he's going to come on up here. You'll hear his remarks about Club Atletico and a little bit about what he does now. I've been trying to connect as much media, and he's got the pulse on soccer abroad, locally. So I had thanks to Terry Bickler for connecting us. So, Dave, come on up.
Thanks, Ricky. Firstly, as I'm late, I caught the ball, so let's get started. I guess, Ricky, thoughts and systems an event at the Missouri History Museum. You should have a history guy here. I wrote Soccer Made in St. Louis, which is the history of soccer in St. Louis. And just from your information, I've been writing about soccer since the early 1970s, believe it or not, like before most of you people were born. I coached as a head coach for 12 years at the old Bush Soccer Club, my son's team. Our son Will is a soccer coach now. He was the women's assistant soccer coach in Indiana State for 3 years, and he's back in St. Louis coaching now. And as I was sitting in the audience waiting for the event to start, I'm trying to think of how to connect this event with the long and rich history of soccer in St. Louis, which goes back to the first game I could find, May 28, 1875. And when I was a student at SIU Edwardsville, my first semester there in the fall of 1973, SIU Edwardsville and St. Louis University were two of the top three or four men's collegiate programs in the United States. And that year, there were four possible national college championships: NCAA Division I men, NCAA Division II men, NAIA, and National Junior College, and St. Louis teams won all four of those. And that was not uncommon. I mean, we just ran the table every year. And not only in 1973 did we win four national championships, out of the eight teams who made the finals that year, six were from St. Louis, or used St. Louis teams, St. Louis players. So we have a long and rich history to look back on. Those days of running the table are long gone. There's no more stark reminder of that than the stadium vote that failed to pass in April to bring MLS here. But as I was sitting here waiting to begin, I was talking to Terry Mickler, who hopefully everybody knows who Terry is, not just the winningest boys soccer coach in St. Louis, but the winningest boys high school coach in the history of soccer in the United States. And Terry and I are talking about what do we need to do to get back there. And we need to do things like Club Atletico is doing, and programs like what Brad Rose is doing with the Cup of Nations, and what Terry's brother Tom and Tim Tam are doing with New Dimensions. If you're not familiar with New Dimensions, look at their website. And working with the immigrant community in St. Louis, using soccer as the way to assimilate immigrants into the St. Louis community. And so it's really exciting to be here tonight to see Club Atletico make this announcement and bring grassroots, high-level men's soccer back to the city of St. Louis, where it all started 140 years ago in the immigrant communities of St. Louis. So I wish Ricky and the owners and the players all the best. I hope they have a great success with this, and I'm looking forward to watching you guys play. Thank you, Ricky.